back to this training series. This is part three, where we're looking at the new hose and nozzle package that's showing up on the Pierce engines here in the city of Dallas. You know, in part one, we looked at, well, what are we getting? What's this package consist of? And then in part two, we looked at how is it different from what we're used to, you know, with the Spartan fleet, with our Echo 10 hose, National hose, and then the TFT automatic fogs. Now, what we want to do in part three is we want to look at practically what does this mean, or what are some of the application points for us, you know, for the average firefighter here in the city of Dallas. You know, the first question that almost always comes up is, okay, you're giving us these three options, right? The tip options on that Elkhart cutoff. You've got the constant gallonage fog, a 7/8 and a 15/16 inch smoothbore tip. So does that mean now I have to know three different, you know, discharge pressures or PDPs depending on what tip we pull or what tip is on the nozzle that we're utilizing? And the answer to that is actually no, okay? The beauty or the genius of this package, okay, is that it has a simplified PDP. So that regardless of which tip you're using, okay, whether you're using the fog, the 7/8 or the 15/16, you can have a singular PDP. Okay, that PDP on the individual line itself is gonna be 165 to 175, okay? Now, I wanna make sure that I put a little bit of an emphasis here, because there's a difference between the actual individual line gauges and then the electronic one that's on the Pierce apparatus. If you're looking at the electronic one, it's gonna read higher. It's gonna read 180, 185, because that's measuring the internal pressure of the pump itself as well on top of the individual line. Okay, so, you know, if you're looking at the individual lines themselves, 165 to 175 is gonna put you smack dab in the middle of those numbers that we talked about before, which is a range of 160 to 185 GPMs. That's a ton of water, guys. Okay, and this is all coming off of our 1¾-inch lines. When we're talking about our our 2½-inch lines, okay, these get a little bit trickier, because, you know, we don't have these set up as a pre-connect with, you know, the five sections like our crosslay giving us that PDP. Okay, the 2½-inch line, remember, we're looking for 50 pounds to the tip, but then we need to add in friction loss, you know, per section or per 100 feet. Now, the way I would do the 2½ is per 100 feet, just to make the math simple, right? So you're gonna have 50 that you need to deliver to the tip plus 15 per 100 feet that you pull off and then you cut, connecting it to one of your discharge lines. And then just remember, with this 2½-inch line, we've got it outfitted with an 1⅛-inch tip, okay? We're delivering 50 pounds to that. That's gonna give us 265 GPMs. So we're bringing a heck of a lot more water to the fight, which is our second point, okay? And that's greater GPMs on our initial attack lines. Now, there's two things that I wanna point out about that. You know, like the firefighting that we do in the city of Dallas is almost always a game of GPMs over BTUs, right? We've gotta bring enough water to the fight in order to overcome the heat and energy that's being produced by that fire. Now, the flip side of this is, okay, we all got this internal clock that's based off of the Spartan apparatus and the TFT nozzles that are flowing less GPMs, right? So we need to make sure that we recalibrate that internal clock on how much time we've got on those lines when we're running off of tank water. So that's important to remember, guys. All right, and now I know that we've talked about this, but I wanna make sure that we make note of it again, okay? The third point is gonna be this, that these lines are gonna have less weight. And as you can see in this video, again, that 2½-inch line is where this is really gonna play out, because now we've got a 2½-inch line that is deployable and manageable and advanceable by one member, and we're bringing 265 GPMs to the fight with that line. So this alone is a game changer for us and adds a huge, you know, a huge plus to our arsenal when it comes to fighting bigger fires, okay? Now, the fourth and the last point is gonna be this, okay? And this is, these lines are gonna have more air. Now, again, remember, we're utilizing Tru-ID hose, which is gonna be a thicker, more rigid hose. And that's gonna play itself out in the sense that we're gonna have more in the line, and there's three things that we need to do in response to that, okay? The first one is this, and this is something that we should be doing regardless of whether you're on a Pierce apparatus or a Spartan apparatus. You need to make sure that you're bleeding these lines off prior to entry. Now, something that we could be doing and we should be doing as another best practice, you know, to bleed that air off faster is how we charge our lines, and going back to our PDPs, right? So when you're charging your lines, what we recommend is that you charge your lines hot. Now, this is regardless of whether you're on a Pierce apparatus, you're on a Spartan apparatus, whether you're utilizing Tru-ID hose or you're using Echo 10 or National hose, you should be charging your lines hot. And when we're talking about charging hot, we're talking about charging that line with 185 to 200 pounds of pressure. And then when you're bleeding that air off, back it down to your 165 to 175 or where you guys have set that for your crew. You know, you've dialed that in when we've done the hands-on training. That's where you would put that in while that air is being bled off. The second thing that we need to be aware of, okay, is how we're gonna load this then because of air that's gonna be introduced into this line. Okay, normally, you know, the fire's out, we disconnect all the lines, we bleed off all the, or we walk off all the water. Then we bring the hose over to the apparatus and we just flat load it back in. We're going to continue to flat load. That's not going to change. But what we're going to do is we're going to roll this hose wet and then bring it over to the apparatus. And then the third piece of that is actually the second step of this, which is we're going to utilize this thing called a bloomin' onion, or what some have called just the onion load, in order to then keep the air out as we load it back. We flat load it back into the tray. So these are some of the practical things that we need to be doing when it comes to this gear. I hope this little three-part series has helped you guys out. The real kicker, guys, is gonna come when we do the hands-on training. So make sure you guys are writing down any questions that you have, and we're gonna put everything we got into that hands-on training and helping you guys understand how to best utilize this equipment. So thanks again, guys, and we'll see y'all next time.